The Premier and Trade Minister have been accused of lying to State Parliament about John Barilaro's New York trade posting. Both have publicly maintained that the first round of recruitment didn't find a suitable candidate. But newly released documents show both men were told a successful applicant was found before her job offer was suddenly withdrawn.
What the Premier called fact has now been rubbished as fiction. Last month, Dominic Perrottet was asked about Jenny West, the public servant who was initially offered the New York trade job that eventually went to John Barilaro.
I'll say this in relation to this matter. I met with the minister this morning and I was advised the following. Here are the facts. The first recruitment process did not identify a suitable candidate.
But this is a briefing document that went to Perrottet's office last August. It shows there was not only a suitable candidate, but a successful one. After a full recruitment process, the successful candidate is Ms. Jenny West. While the document wasn't signed and the Premier has said he doesn't remember seeing it, emails from his office staff suggest it was noted. The same briefing note went to Stuart Ayres. Despite putting his signature to it, the now Trade Minister also told Parliament...
It's important to recognise here that at the end of that first round of recruitment, that there was no suitable candidate identified.
These documents put beyond doubt that the story that the Premier and Minister Ayres has been telling the public isn't true.
From a trade trip in India, Minister Ayres has denied the claim, saying this brief notes information provided by Investment New South Wales. It is not a brief which seeks a decision from me. I would also like to make clear that this brief does not represent the end of the recruitment process. The documents have been released under a parliamentary order, and while providing some new detail, the vast majority have been declared top secret. The upper house will hold an emergency sitting on Friday to fight that secrecy claim.
We will not accept the cover-up. We will not accept that.
For all the tough talking, it does remain unclear what will actually happen when both houses of parliament return in 2 weeks. With Drummoyne MP John Sidoti facing suspension, the numbers are increasingly tight in the lower house, and Labor could move to censure both the Premier and the Trade Minister. A big apple blue that's far from melting away. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.